time to do the chick chores. Hey, Jan, quick thought for you. I know the boss has his own special segment called Doing Dishes with the Boss, but I think we could make a special segment that is doing chick chores, or even better, wiping chick butts. One thing about getting chicks from the hatchery is that you need to check their bottoms. I do it every day for the first couple weeks because little guy, because they will actually get poop built up so much. Whoa. Look at this guy. So handsome. This was one of ours. Uh-huh. He's a Brahma Comet. They will get so much poop built up that they actually cannot go poop anymore. So we're on day 4 with these guys. And yeah, most of the ones that I've been having problems with are looking much, much better. But the other thing is I pull them all out of here, and then I can go through and actually clean their bedding. Now, with how deep this thing is, all I really need to do is add more bedding. So I can go a foot thick if I need to, but I add fresh bedding every morning and every night. Somebody come here. Every morning and every night, so that they don't smell as bad. Right, guys. Right, too fast. Poopy butt stage. You know, all of our chicks that we've hatched ourselves, except the silkies, have never had a problem with poopy butts. The only ones that seem to have problems are the hatchery ones. I think it's because of the shipping. You're a tubby guy. Maybe good food. All right, baby. Hello. Yes, you're pretty too. I love these Brahma Comet chicks. These are gorgeous. They're also bigger. And they feel a little bit heavier. Maybe that's just my bias coming through. I'm really hoping that the chicks that I hatch can keep up with these meat birds. If they do, then no more buying birds for me. Gosh, guys, we're doing great today. No real problem, child. There's one. Another one. I know, big guy. I know. It's gotta be weird. Right, only 2 out of 68. Pretty good. I use the boards to keep my feeders and waters up out of the shavings, which keeps them cleaner. Feed. Now, these chicks will go through a crazy amount of water and feed, but water is the most important one. So, I have a 2-gallon bucket with a cup water just in case they run out of regular water and I haven't gotten to them. And the other thing that I do, I have an old tray. I'll fill this with grit, just sand and stuff from our driveway, and put that in there for them to kind of pick through. Okay, I think they're ready to go back in.
Oh.